Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about the estimate of parameters of one-way classification. So here we have yij, the model after estimating the parameters. Yij is equal to mu plus alpha I plus epsilon ij. Mu is estimated as mu double dot bar plus alpha I is equal to mu I y double dot bar plus y I dot bar minus y double dot bar plus epsilon I j is y I j minus y I dot bar. So this is the model. Now partitioning the sum of squares. This is done by considering this y double dot bar to LHS, shifting this, we get yij minus y double dot bar, and squaring it and taking summation over I and j, this becomes double summation yij minus yi dot bar, this term, plus yi dot bar minus y double dot bar whole square, summation over I and j. Now this is of the form a plus b whole square. This can be expanded like a square plus b square plus 2ab. So this becomes double summation yij minus yi dot bar whole square plus double summation yi dot bar minus y double dot bar whole square plus 2 double summation yi dot bar minus y double dot bar yij minus yi dot bar. This is equal to double summation yij minus yi dot bar whole square plus I is equal to 1 to k and j is equal to 1 to ni. So this is independent of j, so we can write the second expression as summation I ni into yi dot bar minus y double dot bar whole square, and the last term vanished since summation over j yij minus yi dot bar equal to 0, since it is algebraic sum of the deviations of the values from their arithmetic mean is always equal to 0. So we have here double summation yij minus y double dot bar whole square is equal to this one. This is nothing but total sum of squares denoted by SST is equal to, this is a sum of squares due to error SSE plus this is due to sum of squares due to treatment SST. In other words, it is abbreviated as ST square is equal to SE square plus S t square. So this way we can partition the various sum of squares. Degrees of freedom. This sum of squares, total sum of squares, is computed from n quantities of the form y ij minus y double dot bar. So the degrees of freedom for this is n minus 1, since one degree of freedom being lost because of the constraint that double summation yij minus y double dot bar equal to 0. Similarly, the sum of squares due to treatment summation ni into yi dot bar minus y double dot bar, this is computed using the terms consisting of this form, and this is equal to 0. Because of this linear constraint, we get the degrees of freedom for this as k minus 1. And finally, for error term, degrees of freedom is yij minus yi dot bar. Here also, error sum of square is will have a degrees of freedom n minus k. It consists of n of quantities of the form double summation yij minus yi dot bar subject to the linear constraint that summation yij minus yi dot bar equal to 0 summation over j. So degrees of freedom for treatment is k minus 1 and corresponding for the error term is n minus k. Hence the degrees of freedom for totality is n minus 1, for treatment it is k minus 1, and for error term it is equal to n minus k. So there we can observe that sum of squares are additive in nature. So degrees of freedom also additive in nature, mean sum of square. The sum of squares divided by the degrees of freedom gives the corresponding mean sum of squares. So here mean sum of squares due to treatment is given by S T square divided by its degrees of freedom k minus 1, that is equal to SST divided by k minus 1, and it is simply denoted by small ST square. Similarly, the mean sum of squares due to error term is SC square by its degrees of freedom dividing by n minus k. This is equal to SSE divided by n minus k is equal to SE square. Expectation of various sum of squares are considered in the next class. Thank you.